already walked the path of Dvaitam. Yeah. Somebody who has walked the path of Dvaitam, he has understood that he needs to recognize the true nature of his own self. And how can that happen? Through his own inner seeing. Not by relying on external people, not by relying on an external practice, not by relying on external rites and rituals or external blessings, external grace, etc., etc. One who realizes these, he sees that these are all like sand castles. I built a sand castle and the wind blew it away. Again I built a sand castle, again the wind blew it away. Again I built a beautiful strong sand castle, again the wind blew it away. Finally, this spiritual seeker comes to the understanding, oh, it's pointless to try to build a home here. It does not work. I used to build material world homes and they got blown away. I started building spiritual world homes and they also got blown away. Aha, there are limitations to the Dvaitam path. There are limitations to practices, rituals, rites, worships, blessings, grace. All this is okay initially for mental and physical relaxation. But it cannot take me to my true self. To go to my true self, the path is within. Dvaitam path is outside. Yeah? So I have to drop the reliance on the external path and I have to look within. This is how Janaka's journey began. In those days, King Janaka went to Gurukul. In Gurukul, they didn't learn just about the sciences. They learned all this as kids. So Janaka was at a stage where he recognized, I am not the body. I am not the mind. He recognized, I am the witness. But he was not established in the witness. He kept slipping again and again and again. Do you see it? Yeah. So he had already recognized, I am not the body. I am not the mind. I am the witness of the body and mind. So now do you understand? If somebody has reached this stage and if somebody is teaching such a person, where will the teaching begin? The teaching will begin at this level that, oh, you recognize, I am the witness. That is where Ashtavakra starts speaking to Janaka. Is this point very clear? Yeah. So now King Janaka has understood, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am the witness of the body and mind. Are you there? Did you all do the contemplation meditation several times and recognize, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am the witness? Yeah. If you did, then you are at Janaka's level. Yeah. This Ashtavakra Samhita for the Ajatavadin is not for the complete beginners. I have done a diluted version of Ashtavakra Gita for the beginners with selected verses from very selected chapters. They are already there on the website and on YouTube. That series is diluted. It is for the Dvaitam path follower, for a beginner. Yeah, Dvaitam path followers means those who are following the bhakti path, the yogic path, the path of practices. Pure Advaita Vedanta path does not have any mixture of these paths. It is the pure Jnana path. Yeah, so who is this Ashtavakra Gita for? For somebody like Janaka, who has recognized, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am the witness of the body and the mind. Even if you have recognized for a glimpse, that's good enough. Have you? Give me a thumbs up. Okay. Then you are qualified to be here. Again, just a word of repetition. The Dvaitam path is not wrong. Nothing is wrong with techniques. Techniques are excellent for the mind to calm down, to de-stress. But techniques do not take me within. The only way I can go within is through self-inquiry. Those who have claimed that they are at Janaka's level, you would have understood experientially the three levels, or at least understood a little. You must have got intellectual understanding of these three levels. What are these three levels? First level, I recognize at the body level, yoga, pranayam, service, seva. All these karma yoga techniques are helpful, but they do not take me beyond. This is at the body level. Yeah. At the mind level, level number two, chanting helps calm down the mind. Reciting the scriptural verses helps calm down the mind. But these are only concentration techniques. They help the mind concentrate. Jnana yoga techniques only help take me beyond, not chanting, scriptures, mantras. Concentration techniques make the mind focus on an object. Jnana techniques, jnana means self-inquiry, make the subject turn inwards and focus on the subject. Very clear? Mind and body level techniques make the subject focus on an object, like a mantra, like the body, like the breath, yeah, or kundalini energy. All this is still external because I am the witness. I am not the body, I am not the mind. So I, the witness, have to focus externally if I have to do techniques at the body and mind level. Yeah, subject is focusing on the object. Now, even emotional level, singing songs in devotion, worshipping a human, worshipping an idol, worshipping rites and rituals that I do, all the bhakti yoga techniques, make me the witness focus externally on the object. So if one has to go beyond the objects, one has to let go of the body level techniques and the mind level techniques. He moves from the object to the subject. This is exactly what Ashtavakra will teach Janaka. What is his main teaching? Your focus is outside. Your focus is on the object. You, the subject, are focusing on the object right now. That is the cause for your failure on the spiritual path. The subject must turn inwards and focus on the subject himself. Then only can you be successful on the spiritual path. Clear? So, body level techniques do not work, mind level techniques do not work, emotional level techniques like worshipping do not work. These three levels I have practiced in the past and become clear that it's time to shed away. Just like A person who does not know how to swim, he cannot swim from one shore of the river to the other shore. So what does he do? He takes a boat. He takes the boat from this shore all the way to that shore. Now, when he reaches that shore, does he say, "Oh, the boat helped me reach here, so I'm going to sit in this boat forever"? No. He has to let go of the boat and start walking on the other shore. Once you have done all your Dvaitam techniques and recognized, "Oh, I have reached the level of I am the witness," you have come to Advaita Vedanta. Now it's time to let go of that boat. You can't keep sitting in the boat. Get off the boat. Yeah. Start moving on the shore. Very clear? Yeah. Dvaitam path, subject focuses on object. Advaita path, subject focuses on subject. Very, very clear how the techniques are designed. Yeah, whether you like it or not, that is the design of the techniques. Dvaitam path techniques are for the body, for the mind, and for the emotional levels. Yeah, subject focusing on the object. Advaita path techniques, all self-inquiry meditations, take you from your focus on the object, turn you inwards towards the subject. Every single self-inquiry meditation will do that on the jnana path, on the please mute yourself, Sabita. Every technique on the Advaita path, on the jnana path, will help you turn inwards and focus inwards. Very clear? So far is clear? Janaka's position is clear? Are you at Janaka's position? Yes? Now you will understand what Ashtavakra tells Janaka. You become very clear. Now Janaka knows the three vadas. Advaita level 1, Srishti Drishti Vada. He knows. What is Srishti Drishti Vada? The creation precedes consciousness is Srishti Drishti Vada. Creation precedes consciousness means what? I used to always feel earlier that this world is permanent. This creation is permanent. It is always there. I, the consciousness, am born in an already existing creation. And I, the consciousness, will die while this creation is permanent. Yes? Creation precedes consciousness. Creation comes before consciousness. That is the meaning of Srishti Drishti Vada. The same mentality I continued as to think that this creation is there throughout the night. I wake up in this creation in the morning and I go to sleep in the night in this creation. The creation is permanent. This is how I used to think at Advaita level 1. Yeah, Janaka was also there. You were also there. Yes. Then you move to Advaita level 2. Exact reverse. Drishti Srishti Vada. Consciousness precedes creation. Drishti Srishti Vada. Here you recognize, no, there is no creation that is always there. I have no direct personal proof that this creation exists before I was born. I have no proof that this creation will continue after I die. I have no proof that this creation exists throughout the night and in the morning I wake up in it. No, I don't have direct personal experiential proof. I only have theory. I have science. I have speculation. I do not have direct personal experience to say, yes, I can prove it that this exists before I wake up in the morning in it. Oh, then your whole perspective changes. You move from level 1 of Srishti Drishtivad to level 2 of Drishti Srishtivad. You move from your previous understanding of creation precedes consciousness to level 2, consciousness precedes creation. Now you start understanding, if this creation does not exist before me, the consciousness, it means I, the consciousness, project this creation. I am first, then this world is projected. So those who started practicing Swapna Nidra Jnana, you must have recognized, first there is the sense of I, then there are images in the mind or thoughts in the mind. Some people don't have images. And then the dream world is projected along with the dream character. The sense of I was first. Consciousness precedes creation. Oh my, dream world is projected after the sense of I. And after the dream world projection, the waking world projection happens after some time. Waking world comes much later. Aha, consciousness precedes creation. I, the consciousness, project this first, the dream world, and then the waking world. Did you manage to get that glimpse at least once in your practice of Swapna Nidra Jnana? Good. Then you move to level 3, Ajatvada, where you recognize actually this so-called projection that I'm calling the dream world and the waking world is not different from I. I is also a thought. The dream world tiger that is chasing that I is also a thought. Oh, what about the waking world that comes later? Oh, that is also a thought. The presence of sight, sound, smell, taste, touch does not prove to me that the waking world is more real than the dream world, because in the dream world also I see, I hear, I heard the tiger in my dream. But these ears were not there. The physical eyes were not there, yet I saw the tiger in my dream. Aha! The sense of I is a thought. The waking world is a thought. The dream world is a thought. All of it is the same. It is the same material, the same matter that it is made of. Oh, the creation does not really exist. I do not have proof in my own direct experience that this creation exists. It appears for a short while, 14, 16 hours, and I label that as the waking state, but it disappears after that. Then the dream world appears for a short while. It stays for some time. That also disappears. How can that which appear and disappear be permanent? Be true? How can I say confidently that it exists? How can I say confidently that it is born? I cannot. I can speculate. I can use theory, I can use science, I can use hypothesis, I can use deductive logic, but none of these are my direct experiential proof. None of this is my own direct experience. So you come to the third level of Advaita, Ajatvada. The creation is unborn. Ajata, unborn. Ajata. there is only consciousness, only knowingness. There is no creation, just like there never was a dream tiger. That dream tiger, was it ever born? No, it never was. Similarly, just like the dream world never was, the waking world is not. There is no creation, ajatavada. So this is how you will progress, srishti drishtivada to drishti srishtivada to ajatavada. Some of us are already at ajatavada, some of us need a little bit more finishing touches to get there. So keep doing your inquiry. As we go through every verse of Ashtavakra, you will get a new inquiry to do. Yeah? So keep doing your inquiry. We all will get there together. Is this very clear? What is going to happen through the verses? See, Ashtavakra benefits the one who doesn't need any basic level understanding of Advaita Vedanta. His basics are clear. Yeah? Such a person only needs a solid grounding in the knowledge that he has already glimpsed before. But he is not established there. Yeah? He's glimpsed it. He's seen it. That which he has seen once, but he has not grown roots in it yet. Yes, such a person will benefit by Ashtavakra Samhita. Yeah? So for that, what do you need to do? You need to marinate in this wisdom. Marination means staying in the wisdom continuously, consistently, ceaselessly, with complete interest. Yeah. So after every verse, I'll give you a restroom break. So your body gets to move around, yeah, you calm down, relax, and again you can focus on the next verse. Yeah. So this entire journey is to take me to the final truth that I am consciousness, the world is consciousness. In fact, there is no I, no world, there is only consciousness. That is the last stage. Yes. So now, for a seeker who has understood as much as Janaka has understood, what is the question that arises in such a person? He has been through Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa, but yet he is not fully established there. He might still have the question that King Janaka asks Ashtavakra in verse 1. You all have the PDFs. We'll do verse 1 now. The PDFs are attached to the email with the Zoom links. Verse 1, Janaka uvacha katham jnanam avapnoti katham muktir bhavishyati vairagyam cha katham praptam etat bruhi mama prabhu. Janaka asks the question, how is wisdom to be attained? Not knowledge, wisdom, two different things, huh? Knowledge is when I learn it the first time, I'm collecting words. Yes, I'm collecting the spiritual words. What is jnana? When these words are used to help me reach there and I recognize my true self, that is jnana. That is wisdom of who I truly am. Yes, so it is not knowledge. How is wisdom to be attained. Wisdom of what? Of who I am. It's the ultimate jnana. He's not asking about a basic understanding of spirituality. He's not asking for a mental wellness technique. He's not asking for a blessing. Please bless me. He's not asking for grace. He's not asking me for a miracle. Please do some miracle so I attain it. No, no. How do I attain it? Big difference, huh? In the question of the seeker is hidden the quality of his spiritual attainment, where he is. Yeah, it's all hidden in the question. He's not interested in any material world attainment. He's a king. He has money, name, fame, kingdom at his beck and call. No, he's not even asking for a spiritual attainment. Some great shakti should be born in me, some great energy. No, no. He's at a level where he is not even interested in this material world happiness. This is the level of the seeker who has already walked the spiritual path for some time and recognized the futility of the material world, the futility of spiritual techniques, futility of rites, rituals, practices, etc. Yeah? Again, they are not futile from the body-mind level. Very good for relaxation of the mind, very good for de-stressing. But they definitely did not get Janaka to the highest truth of I am consciousness. So he's asking, katham, katham jnanam avapnoti. How I've been walking so long? So many techniques, so many gurus, so many practices. How? Right? This is true inner yearning. The ultimate step to latch into the primordial awareness. Give me that. That is what he's asking. Yeah. So that is the first question about jnana. Second question is katham muktir bhavishyati. Mukti, he wants liberation. Liberation from what? He has seen, I get trapped into this waking world. It's so tempting, it's so wonderful. Yeah, it traps me, it enamors me. And I start believing this is real. I want mukti from this belief. I want liberation from this false belief. Are you seeing his level of question? He's not saying, oh, I want mukti from the worldly sadness. No, no. He's not so petty. He's saying, what worldly sadness? I want mukti from the worldly happiness also. I want mukti from this waking world illusion that comes up and traps me. How do I get liberated from this samsara? Now, the samsara is not just this waking world illusion, it's also the dream world illusion and the darkness of deep sleep. Because the darkness of deep sleep gives me an illusion that I was absent. That is a very big illusion to have, and some of us had that for years together. Yes, that's why when somebody asked you, how was your sleep? Wonderful. I slept like a baby. I slept so soundly. Okay, that's wonderful. What happened in your deep sleep? I don't know. I was not there. Two contradictory statements. First statement, so confidently you say, I slept so well. That means I, the one who got rest, was there. And I know about the rest. I know about the peace. Exactly opposite and contradictory is your second statement where you say, I was not there. Are then who is saying that I slept soundly? Contradictory. Oh, I want mukti from these contradictions. I want liberation from this wrong understanding. I say both opposite things. Which is true? This is true or this is true? Even deep sleep confuses me. Not just the waking world and the dream world are Maya. Even the darkness of deep sleep is Maya. Oh, I want mukti from this. I want mukti from this wrong understanding. Clear? Katham muktir bhavishyati. That is the meaning of wanting liberation. And what is a petty person wants liberation from? Oh, give me mukti from this dukkha, from this bad person, this bad relationship. He is only focused on the object, the waking state. Yeah? Ashtavakra means subject focuses on subject, not subject focusing on object. Yes? Will you remember this for every single verse? Yeah? Subject focuses on subject. Third question. Vairagyam cha katham praptam. How can I attain complete dispassion? Please tell me. Now, I keep getting trapped into this waking world despite seeing and knowing that this is my projection. Despite knowing this is unreal, I am that witness, that absolute nothingness in which waking world and waking body mind appear for a few hours and then they disappear. I see this projection. I know this projection. I am very clear about this. But yet I get enamored. I get lost in it. Why do I get lost? Oh, I am passionate about something in the waking world. I am passionate about maybe the body mind that I assume myself to be in the waking world, or something related to that waking personality in the waking world. I'm very passionate about it. That passion is what is pulling me away from reality. So I want dispassion from that tempting projection. Vairagyam. Very clear? Please remember again, Janaka is not a beginner of the spiritual path. That is why the scripture is not such a popular scripture. Yeah? Beginner scriptures are very popular. No? This begins only direct at the witness level. But you have to recognize I'm not the body, I'm not the mind. Then you can start walking the path of witnessing. Yeah? So this is a higher level scripture. That is why it is not a popular scripture. If Janaka were a beginner, what would his questions be? I want to attain health, wealth, success, name, fame. I want many more kingdoms. I want to be an emperor of many kingdoms, not just one single kingdom. I want good relationships. I want many, many wives. No. Janaka is not asking for all that because he has recognized, oh, I am that bed of nothingness or awareness in which there is the sense of I that arises. Then after that sense of I, the dream world arises, stays for a while, disappears. Then the waking world arises, stays for a longer while and disappears. Then I notice even the sense of I disappears. But I am still there. I am permanent. I am continuous. I am that substratum in which again the sense of I arises. Then again the dream world arises. Again the waking world arises. Oh, this cycle goes on and on and on. I want to find that truth. That which I am. And I want to be established there. I don't want to glimpse it for 1 minute or 1 hour or 2 hours. I want to be established in that truth. Questions very, very clear? Yeah. He is seeking wisdom, liberation, and dispassion. Such questions occur only to somebody who has walked the path and reached an advanced stage in his journey. So, last warning from verse 1. The scripture is useful only for the few who are seeking nothing but enlightenment. Time to contemplate. Do I have such a strong yearning like Janaka? Ask yourself this question. Am I seeking enlightenment? Is this journey for me? We'll take 5 minutes to contemplate on this and take a restroom break and then come back for verse 2, because verse 2 we are going to sit a long time. Yeah? So only 5 minutes restroom break and 5 minutes contemplation.